In 2000, he left Moscow on a private jet seeking asylum in Britain. At the height of his wealth, Boris Berezovsky had an estimated net worth of $3 billion.
13 years later, he died, nearly broke, and here's what he spent it on. Property, not just any old house, several sprawling country mansions with bulletproof glass for him and his children. He spent about $40 million on this one. It's in Wentworth Park in Surrey, and this is the home he died in. He also spent money on political campaigns, mostly attacks against his former friend turned foe, Vladimir Putin. And for years, he bankrolled the push for an inquest into the death of his friend and fellow exile, ex-KGB agent Alexander Litvinenko, murdered by radiation poisoning. And that's when it all started to slide. His wife filed for divorce in 2010. The exact amount is not known, but it is estimated he had to pay out hundreds of millions of dollars in the split.
Last year, he was hit with a spectacular defeat in court when he sued fellow Russian oligarch Roman Abramovich for $5.6 billion over a business deal that turned sour. He lost and now reportedly owes more than $100 million in legal fees. Then his girlfriend, Elena Gorbunova, put a freeze on the sale of his assets, demanding her share of their Wentworth Park country home. By his last week, he was reduced to selling his art collection, including this, an Andy Warhol original portrait of Vladimir Lenin, which sold for nearly $75,000. His friends say he was brokering a deal to return to Russia. In the end, it seems he died alone. For all the power and money he once had, it was his bodyguard who found him on his bathroom floor. Atika Shubert, CNN, London.